Hello guys, and welcome back. And today we're going to create this portal effect using some of the alpha that we created through our last tutorial. And now they look like this, a kind of smoky effect, a dot, a shockwave effect, and a swirly kind of twisted effect, and a thickening one, just in case we don't like the other one. And that's all it takes to create this effect. And obviously with some adjustments in Unity. So let's dive into that one. So I'm gonna hide this one. I'm gonna hide it. We're gonna create another one, and we're gonna name this portal number two. And then again, vertical system. We're gonna start with the outside waves, and go ahead and drag all your textures in there if you haven't already, and then try to create a port on the materials in there. As you can see, I already got one going on, so I'm gonna go ahead and create the rest. Once you have all the materials created, we can go ahead and start creating the first element of our particle system. I'm gonna start with wave, so I'm gonna drag the wave material in there, and I'm gonna check off shape and zero speed, because we want that thing to be stationary, and then maybe increase the size a bit. And the first thing I'm gonna do is have this thing rotate, rotational over time. Let's have it as default right now. It's not really looking like a portal, it's more like an eye, like a Sharingan, whatever, if you know what I mean. My nerdness is coming up. Anyway, we're gonna change the maximum particle to 10, because the reason is doing that because we have like 1,000 of them happening at once. That's why everything is like circular motion. So we're gonna change that to 10. Maybe have the emitter to have do it two at a time, and then it's back to this because it's spawning longer. So I'm gonna change that maybe to 3. And then have a phase in, kind of like a phase in fade up effect. Actually, that's what that looks like with one. One looks better. And now I'm gonna have a phase in fade out effect with a alpha. So at the beginning is zero, at the end is zero. So they kind of like phase in and phase up. And to add more variety to it, I mean, this could pretty much done, but we can do better. We can go a little bit forward with this. I'm going to change the size over life and have this to be small and then kind of like pausing up looking, if you know what I mean. Have it like that. Change the rate over time to maybe, let's see, 2? 2 might be a little bit too much. I think 0.5. 0.5 works. And that's perfect. Maybe increase the speed a little bit. I'm liking this one. Let's see, what else can we do to make this one slightly better? Maybe not have it not as fast. Ah, I like this. So initially you can see it's kind of like popping in, popping up. If we like decrease the size, speed a little bit, it's looking pretty dope. Right now it's still looking like very, very flat at the moment, but if we like change the color, so let's do green, because why not? So green on the inside, blue maybe on the outside, and then in the middle, the whiteness part, gonna change that to purple. No, that doesn't work with the rest. I like this one, it's kind of giving that spooky effect going on. And you can like adjust how glowy this one is by change the emission over time, obviously. I think 0.5 works better for me. And you can kind of try some other, this way works, but I like this one better. Let's do that. Maybe increase the particle size to 100. There we go. That's looking much, much smaller. And I think I'm gonna call this one done. And the next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna create another particle system. Where it is, there it is. We want that to be inside this. And then going to name this. I'm going to start with the rain, which is the... Damn it. I'm going to start with the rain, which is the... This one right here. Drag that one in. It's kind of the... Kind of a... a pulsive effect that will be around... Around the... this really... The portal itself. Same thing. No shape. And then zero speed. Zero speed. Actually, I guess we can... We could just duplicate that one, but yeah, we can do that later, next time. And then have this one much bigger than the portal itself. Think 3.5 works. Let's see, 4. I'm going to go with 3.5. And then we're going to, again, rotate this thing. But this time, I'm going to do something a little bit differently. And instead of rotating over time, I'm going to have it rotate initially and... It's going to be random between two constant. So I'll have it 360 at the start, 360 at the end. And as you can see, it's kind of like self-animating a little bit, which is kind of pretty cool. But right now, it's too much. We can decrease that to maybe 2, and then boom. It's doing that. Actually, no, that's not what we want. Let's do 50 for now, and then to keep that pulsing effect. Well, yeah, phase in, fade out effect. And then decrease the alpha back a little bit to get that nice roundness of it. And that's pretty much done with this one itself. Let's see, with color added in. Yo, that's pretty cool, actually. I'm going to leave this one like that. Alright, the next thing we're going to do is we're going to create a trail effect that's kind of going in the portal. It's like a little spark that just adds to it. So I'm going to rename this trails. Put that in our folder. And then drag our materials in there. And the first thing we're going to do is zero out the position as well as the rotation itself. And then it's going backward right now. We don't want that to happen. We want it to kind of just emitting from the outside of the ring and then kind of goes in a bit. We can change that easily by going to shape where it has cone. Right now it's in a cone shape. If we just change that to a circle right away, it's only emitting from the flat area here. It should have a better result if we just zero out the speed. There we go. So it's only emitting in the circle area that you tell me to do with the radius that we have control over. So if you want it to spread a bit bigger, you can do that. So I'm gonna have that match the size of our ring. And the next thing we want to do is down here, the radius thickness, we're gonna change that all the way to 0. Do you guys see the difference? So once it's at 0, you're only telling it to emit it in the edges of the circle. Having it at full 0, meaning that it will generate in the within the whole circle and just randomly, but having that as 0, it will only emit at the edge of the circle, which is what we wanted. But that's a little bit too big, so I'm gonna change that, decrease that size to maybe 0.2. Nope, too small. 0.5, too big. 0.4, that's a good number. Have that as 0.4 and have maybe more than just 10, just do 50, just have a crap ton of them going in. And then we want it to go inward, right? We want it to go to inward, so we're gonna add a little bit of speed to it. All we do is just hit negative and typing any number just to see what the result you have. I like in this one, but it could be a little bit faster. Let's do 0.3. Yeah, speed wise, I like it. Don't worry about whatever is in the center right now, because we can tell it to stop at this area by trending down the lifetime. So if we go 3, 2, no, 1.5 would be a good number to have it like going in and stop at this area. And if we're looking at our game view, I'm liking this effect. It's pretty dope. Maybe have it, no, I think that's enough emitter. We're gonna increase the speed. No, I like the speed. What we can do a size over life to give it a more variety, so to start off big and it slowly like fades away. Much, much better. I have a, like a phase in, fade out effect like we always have. So color, again. I already pre-made one of these. Zero at the start and zero at the end. And after that, maybe we can do a bit more with it. There we go. I'm liking this. It's looking pretty dope. I'm gonna call this done and not add a color to it. So let's see. What color do we want? Let's do blue. Why not? Blue is a good color. Blue. It's awesome. Let's see. Sky blue. Perfect. And obviously, you can do whatever color you want. And let's look at all our effects together. It's looking pretty dope. It's pretty cool right now. And the last thing we're gonna do, technically you don't have to do that. We're gonna duplicate this trailer. I'm gonna name this smoke, just to add a little bit more variety to it, adding our smoke texture to it. And instead of going in, we just want it to kind of spurt around on the outside area. So we're gonna change the radius. Well, we're gonna first of all zero speed and increase the size a bit more. There we go. Just to get that nice smoky effect going. It's like, because energy is there, like unsettled is the way to go it. Could be too big at the moment. One. Actually, not too big. Increase the radius so that it's on the outside area. There we go. And that's essentially done. There is our portal effect right there. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.